Hello everybody, my name is Greg Allen and I'm a senior sales engineer with Actian. What I want to show you today is how you can leverage Avalanche Connect to process healthcare data and helping you become HIPAA compliant. This healthcare demo showcases how you can use Avalanche Connect to extract, transform, and load electronic healthcare claims into Avalanche to generate analytic insights for your BI dashboard. It's a collection of automated workflows that facilitate the movement, the transformation, validation, and loading of healthcare claims into an enterprise data warehouse for BI purposes. It's an integration framework that segments the workflow by common tasks, such as inbound, outbound, and analytics, and it leverages templates that illustrate the usage of common healthcare connectivity components, including EDI X.12, HL7, in addition to the HIPAA 5010 schema packs that we provide out of the box with Avalanche Connect. These templates also allow interfacing with common endpoints such as secure FTP, message queues, files, and databases. And all of this is a sample implementation that addresses the HIPAA guidelines for the electronic exchange of healthcare information for data governance purposes. So the outcome is that we're going to transform EDI formatted data, which you see here on the screen, into a more structured data model for BI purposes. So let's go ahead and jump right into the demo. We're going to start by looking at the Avalanche Connect Design Studio and reviewing each step of the workflows that I've mentioned. Let's look at the inbound flow in this particular process. What we're doing is we're picking up an EDI or healthcare formatted file that resides locally on my disk. Then we're going to encrypt it and compress the data before storing it into a secure FTP location. And like with anything designed within the Avalanche Connect, you can test run each of these integrations right out of the Design Studio, which I'm going to do right now. So I'm going to go ahead and execute this integration. And as this process executes, it gives us a step-by-step indication of everything that happened on the Results tab. For further information, we can take a look at the runtime log file to verify that everything worked as intended. In this particular case, an input file was found, it had a valid size, and then we could just verify that by going to the secure FTP location and doing a refresh on the folder. We will now see that we have an archive file that's compressed and encrypted. So looking at the next workflow, the outbound workflow, we're going to pick up that compressed and encrypted file from the secure FTP location. And then we're going to unpack it, decrypt it, send it to a validation process. Then going to send the payload directly into a Microsoft message queue. We support other message queues as well, such as WebSphere MQ, JMS queues, Oracle Advanced Queuing, and others. So let me go ahead and execute this in the Design Studio. So as this integration executes, once again, it will give us step-by-step results. Again, here in the Results tab, we get further information as to what happened in this process to verify that it actually did what it's supposed to do. Let's take a look at our message queue. And if I do a refresh on the message queue, I will now see one message populated in this queue. If I take a closer look at the payload of this message, I can see that it is still EDI or healthcare formatted data now packed into a message fragment. So let's go to the next step. Now we have the information from the secure FTP. We validated the data and now the healthcare claim data is in the message queue. So in the final workflow, we'll take the data from the message queue and send it to a transformation to finally map the data straight into the data warehouse. So there are three steps here in this workflow. First, we're going to connect to the message queue. Then we're going to read the message queue and finally execute a map that uses our pre-built schema pack to transform the data from its native EDI format straight into the data warehouse. So I'm going to go ahead and execute this process in the same fashion as the other two workflows. Now in the results tab, we see the transformation is active. It's reading a number of records and then outputting them directly into the data warehouse. This takes a few seconds to complete as it transforms all the claims that are embedded in that file that we've read from the message queue. Once this integration finishes, we can take a closer look at the details. We can see that we've processed a number of records here that were part of the data that was in the message queue. All of the table operations necessary to interface with the data warehouse are handled by Avalanche Connect, such as creating the table if needed, and other operations such as inserting or updating the data. So if we want to take a peek at the Avalanche Query Editor, we can take a look and see that previously we didn't have any claimed data here. So if I re-execute my select count statement, I'll now see that it has data embedded in it. In the particular archive, it's separated into both claims and service lines. So now that the data is in my data warehouse, I've normalized that data from an EDI format into a columnar type data model. And once the data is in the data warehouse, it can be used as a data source for any BI tool, such as Tableau, Google Looker, or Qlik. And that's really all there is to the Avalanche Connect healthcare demo. Once again, we're taking structured data from the healthcare, we're separating the claims from the service lines, and then we're populating a data warehouse using Avalanche Connect. Let's take a look at the data validation subflow. Avalanche Connect not only facilitates the movement and transformation of healthcare data directly into a data warehouse, but also performs basic data validation syntax checking to ensure that all the data segments and data that make up this highly structured data format called HIPAA is valid. This is commonly referred to as the TA1 data validation process that then generates an acknowledgement known as a 999 or 997 validation to confirm that everything is segmented and formatted in the correct way. And more importantly, we're using one of the pre-built schema files that come right out of the box with Avalanche Connect. And that is really what helps speed up the design and development of healthcare-related data integrations, because these schemas are very complex, consisting of thousands of different segments and loops. And this is the schema pack that allows you to save a lot of time building this out. Imagine if you had to custom code all the metadata associated with that healthcare data, then it would take a very long time to implement. And that's one of the common challenges we see with healthcare payers and providers that process healthcare data, such as healthcare claims. Another standard supported by the schema pack is HL7, which is very similar to the HIPAA standard or EDI standard, but HL7 focuses more on clinical data versus healthcare claims data. But in the same fashion, we're using the same components and the same type of artifacts to be able to process HL7 type information, such as the patient registry. So hopefully this has given you a better understanding of how Avalanche Connect can help accelerate building solutions to handle healthcare data in a data warehouse environment. Thank you very much.
For more on the Actian Healthcare Data Analytics Hub, powered by Actian Avalanche Cloud Data Warehouse and Avalanche Connect, or to get started with a live demo or free trial today, go to actian.com/solutions/healthcare analytics.